There's been a lot of attention on vitamin D deficiency after the COVID-19 pandemic hit the world. And the reason for this is that there have been fairly convincing studies which have come that if you look at those who died due to COVID-19, they seem to have had vitamin D deficiency. Often I'm asked, how can you have vitamin D deficiency in a tropical country like India, where the sun is shining every day? After all, vitamin D is considered as a sunshine vitamin, and we have a lot of sunshine. So how can anybody have vitamin D deficiency? It's a paradox that in India, with so much of sunshine almost throughout the year, 55% of the population has vitamin D deficiency in a recent study that we published in the British Journal of Nutrition. And if you look at those with diabetes, it is 63% who have vitamin D deficiency, and in those with obesity, 80% had vitamin D deficiency. How does this occur? Because although there is sunshine outside, we are not in the sun all the time. And that's why I want you to know five facts about vitamin D deficiency. Number one, vitamin D deficiency is so common that 60 to 80% of you watching this video probably have vitamin D deficiency. Number two, if you want to get vitamin D from the sunlight, you have to spend a considerable amount of time in the sun, especially from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And you must be in the sun for quite some time, more than 30 minutes to 1 hour or 2 hours. You should not have a lot of clothing on, as that will protect the sunlight from hitting the skin directly. So it's very difficult. We as Indians don't like to go and sit in the sun and get tanned. In fact, we use sun creams. And if you use sun cream, you're not going to get your vitamin D, because the sun cannot hit directly into your skin, where this vitamin D is synthesized from the cholesterol. The third thing is, can we get it from diet? It's quite easy for the non-vegetarians, because in fatty fish, many types of fatty fish contain omega-3. The cod liver oil gives you vitamin D. Beef liver is supposed to give you a lot of vitamin D. But these are not things which people eat commonly. And for the vegetarians, where do you get vitamin D from? There are very few sources of vitamin D in vegetarian food. Portobello mushrooms are supposed to be one, especially if they are UV irradiated. Then you get vitamin D from there. Vitamin D fortification is there in some of the products that we consume, such as milk, orange juice, cereals, and so on. So if you're taking those which are already fortified, you may be lucky to get some vitamin D. And egg yolk, and a few other things also may contain vitamin D. But generally, it is not sufficient to increase your vitamin D level, and that's why many of us have vitamin D deficiency. So the fourth thing is that you can take a vitamin D supplement. It's quite easy to take the vitamin D supplement. It comes in sachets of 60,000 units or in capsules of 2,000 units. If you take one capsule per day, you'll get 60,000 in a month. But the fifth point I want to tell you is, don't take the vitamin D supplementation just randomly like that, getting it from a pharmacy and then taking it, because there could be side effects. Suppose you have a impaired renal function, kidney function, then you can have vitamin D toxicity. It's very unlikely that with these kind of oral doses that you take that you develop vitamin D toxicity. It's only when you inject yourself with large doses, 150,000, 300,000, those are the people who develop toxicity. But never take it without prescription. Ask your doctor. Vitamin D is not just for bones. It is not just for muscle health. It also is related to insulin resistance, to obesity, diabetes, heart disease, hypertension, and even some forms of cancer. So I think it's high time that you talk to your doctor about vitamin D, check your vitamin D levels, and see whether it's normal or low or very low. And if you have a deficiency of vitamin D, it's so easy to treat it that this is one way to improve your immunity and protect yourself from infections such as COVID-19.